In India, according to the National Crime Report Bureau 2015, more than 1 lakh persons were killed and more than 4 lakh persons injured in road traffic crashes in 2014. A government report indicated a loss of to the economy of 3% of GDP in 1999 to 2000 due to road mishaps compared to 1.5% for other middle-income countries. It was reported that the total number of road accidents in 2015 was more than 5 lakhs, which is 2.5% more than 2014. National highways accounted for 29% road deaths in 2015 as compared to 29.9% in 2014. State highways registered 28% death last year, and 54.1% of all persons killed in road accidents were in the 15 to 34 years age group during the year 2015. Road transport plays a vital role in the economy of the country, and this sector continues to constitute 4.5% of the GDP of the country. To address the issue faced by the transport sector, the Motor Vehicles Bill 2016 was introduced in Lok Sabha on August 9, 2016 by Ministry of Road Transport and Highway, Mr. Nitin Gadkari ji. This new law intends to have the numbers of the deaths and injury due to road accidents by 2020. The bill has many good provisions, sir. Due to the paucity of the time, I will just mention the good things. Cashless treatment for road accident victims, inclusion of good Samaritan guidelines, aggregator license, empowering central government to recall vehicles, electronic monitoring, national registry for license and registrations, national transportation policy, compensations and insurance, the higher penalties for road traffic violations. But sir, there are some points which I want to raise. The bill lacks clarity with regard to the limited liability of third-party insurance under Section 147 of the Act and Clause 49 of the bill. It caps the maximum liability for third-party insurance in case of a motor accident at INR 10 lakhs and in case of death and INR 5 lakhs in case of grievous injury. This implies that the insurance company is liable to pay only up to these specified amounts. However, the bill does not cap the compensation amount to be decided by the courts. If the courts award compensation amounts higher than the maximum liability prescribed under the bill, it is unclear who will pay the remaining amount. The need for new fund is unclear. For already existing fund under hit and run cases, with the solidarity fund already existing, the purpose of the new motor vehicle accident fund, which regard to
honourable member, one second please,
is unclear.
One second. I would like to draw the attention of member. Still, we have the names of our 7 members who want to speak on this bill. If the house agrees, we may take up the private member's business after all these members speak. And I hope House agrees. Yeah, please continue.
The need for new fund is unclear for already existing fund under hit and run cases. With the solidarity fund already existing, the purpose of the new motor vehicle accident fund with regard to hit and run cases is unclear. For example, there is no clarity on whether accident victims can seek compensation for a particular hit and run case from either or both funds. Further, if the proposed motor vehicle accident fund is funded through a sales or a tax, motor vehicle owners may have to pay taxes in addition to paying the compulsory third-party insurance premium. The bill does not provide any clarity on central guideline for aggregator companies. As per the bill state, government would be issuing licenses to aggregators in conformity with the guidelines issued by the central government. But the bill does not specify what these guidelines will cover. There is a lack of clarity on who should bear the cost of implementing and ensuring electronic monitoring and enforcement of road safety. Ensuring electronic monitoring...
Madam, please conclude now.
In a, 1 minute, sir, yeah. I am concluding.
Yeah, yeah, please.
In a state could near a significant amount of infrastructure investment on part of the state, such as CCTV cameras, speed detectors, training program, etc., the bill does not specify whether such costs will be borne through a central scheme or through additional grants to states from the center. According to the statement on objects and reasons, the bill seeks to address issues related to road safety. While the bill addresses several of these issues, various experts have highlighted other concerns with regard to road safety, absence of agency responsible for road safety, poor road design and engineering. Thank you, sir. I have a high regard to Honorable Minister. I wholeheartedly support the bill. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.